watching Inside Second Life with Sophia Yates. Coming up next, it's Sophia Yates Inside Second Life.
And then when SL crashes.
Yes, hello. You
know. Oh my God, like Second Life crashed again. And like I logged back on and I was a man. And then I logged back on again and I was a panda. And then Second Life crashed again. Yeah.
I know, it's so true. I end up in places I've never been before. I have no clue.
Yeah, sometimes you're going through SL and, you know, things happen.
Oh, my God. Like, Second Life crashed again. And, like, I logged back on, and I was a man. And then I logged back on again, and I was a panda. And then Second Life crashed again. Yeah!
All right, let me...
Oh, my God. Like, Second Life crashed again. And, like, I logged back on, and I was a man. And then I logged back on again, and I was a panda. And then Second Life crashed again. Yeah!
Welcome to the world of lag.
That I'm the happiest avatar in all of Second Life. It's true. It really is. Oh, dear.
If there's a man to do a voiceover for your corporate presentation, right now, you know that you can move forward with this. Or if you need a voice of God with real balls, you know the man to call, Voice Dude Rainoir. You can listen to his voiceover demos at Vox Humana, or you can go to the website I've created for SL content. I mean, well, promotion. Okay, www.slvoiceovers.com.
That's right. I created a website for SL. Keeps
perfect.
Me anonymous. It's www.slvoiceovers.com.
Yeah. You know,
there's 10 seconds of audio. That's one problem.
That's so right.
It's like you can string them together, but then again, you have the lag problem, so they don't always go the same.
No.
I have one gesture with the audio plays twice, which I think is my ball chair. Yeah. I have an Aero ball chair in my shop. If you want to come to Vox Humana and hear my voices, you'll also get to see my beautiful, beautiful ball chair.
Ball chair.
Here it goes.
I love my ball chair.
I love my ball chair.
Here's my ball chair gesture.
One moment.
I love my ball chair.
Sure.
I love my ball chair.
I love my ball chair.
Spin.
B-L-I-P.
BLIPTV.com.
TV. Uh-huh.
Sophia Yates.
BLIPTV.com.
I put more movies on there now because the quality is so much better than YouTube.
Oh, than YouTube?
Yeah, the audience is greater on YouTube. There's no greater audience than YouTube.
No.
Yeah, there really isn't. But,
you're totally right.
You know, I feel like this is a major social experiment, basically.
It is totally amazing. This is amazing, and
yeah,
I personally, just really quick, I want to tell you an exciting thing. I'm very childlike at 46. Don't have a girlfriend, don't have a wife, but I'm totally straight. It's very unusual. Anyway, I don't know if I'd want you to have on it, but I just, after tonight, what? Such a star that doesn't matter what I say. So I bought a 1 gigabyte hard drive. One terabyte. 1 gigabyte. I bought a 1 gigabyte. That's funny because, you know, 5 years ago, that would have been like, oh, my God, he has a 1 gigabyte? He must have a jazz drive, which, of course, I did buy when they had the jazz drives. That was amazing. 1 whole gigabyte on that little disk.
I know.
About a 1 terabyte external hard drive for the fraps, just for the fraps.
Yes.
And it totally kicks ass. Is that what you got, too?
No.
500 gigabyte hard drives paired together. And one external drive with circuit board.
Two 500 gigabytes?
They don't have such thing as a 1 terabyte single hard drive yet at this point. The most they've been able to do as far as, you know, at least commercially, is 500 gigabytes each. Is the way they make this, it's made by, it's not Mac Store, but it's one of the big ones.
Okay.
Anyway, it's two 500 gigabyte hard drives paired together in a single attractive-looking black box. It looks like they call it the something book, like workbook or something. And you can get it on, there's a guy selling a bunch of them on YouTube. I mean, sorry, not YouTube, eBay.
eBay, yeah.
And I actually got mine for about $211 after shipping. They retail for about $400, I think, or
really?
$375. I absolutely love this 1 terabyte drive. It's just wow. To be able to just go, I'm at a concert. This is what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
I wanted to be able to sit, like go to Maximilian Clean, who's my favorite right now. Mm-hmm. Go to one of his concert and just press my trigger number and just record as to my heart's content and not have to worry about the hard drive. That's why I got that 1 terabyte mother. Actually, I got a 500 gigabyte and it was bad, and I returned it, and I actually got a full refund with shipping, and they paid for my shipping to ship it back. That was lucky. That was great. I mean, it was good that I didn't lose out, because with eBay, you're always a crapshoot. And then I thought, okay, I get another 500 gigabyte drive, because that one didn't work out, and I want to do my fraps. So I went searching for a 500 gigabyte drive, and I saw a 1 terabyte drive. I went, you know. Now I'm starting to look at 1.5 and 2 terabyte hard drives, huge, heavy. And I think, not quite. I don't need that much right now.
Yeah, so. You do.
Well, then again, yeah. Oh, but you would more than I would. But I love your sound effects. I love the set. I love the whole area with the trees. And
I love it, too. It's
I still
very
never
cool
get tired of, you know. If you want to start rolling, I can tell you my experience of how I found SL and how voiceovers led me to SL.
Okay, let's go sit down on the set. And then, let me stand up. Stand up. Stand up.